Autoimmune disorders are a growing concern, and the cause is not entirely clear, but here's a fascinating theory. Our clean lifestyles and sanitation practices may be contributing to the problem.
Since the 1950s, there has been a sharp decline in infectious diseases. It's all thanks to vaccines, antibiotics, and sanitation practices that have killed, prevented, and contained the spread of harmful bacteria. But here's the thing. During the same period, autoimmune diseases and allergies have skyrocketed. Rates of diseases like multiple sclerosis, Crohn's disease, type 1 diabetes, and asthma have increased by 300%. And a similar trend has been observed with food allergies. So what's going on? Well, it seems that the world we now live in may be too clean for our own good. Don't get me wrong, it's great that we have clean water, efficient waste disposal methods, and good hygiene practices to protect ourselves from harmful bacteria. But in the process, we have also reduced the number of beneficial bacteria we come into contact with. And we kind of need both. The hygiene hypothesis proposes that allergies and autoimmune diseases occur because our immune systems did not get the right training when we were kids. See, when we're young, the immune system is trying to figure out what's harmful and what's not. And that means it needs to be exposed to both harmful and beneficial bacteria. If the immune system does not get the proper training, then it might consider something like dust or even one of our own proteins as a dangerous invader and initiate an allergic or autoimmune response. And it is not only sanitation practices changing the bacteria we interact with. Cesarean sections and broad spectrum antibiotics also increase the risk of allergies, asthma, and other conditions by reducing the diversity of bacteria we are exposed to. And just the world that we live in now, we have transitioned from living on farms and in rural areas to living in cities. That in itself has been a huge change in the microbial landscape. In fact, there is a good body of evidence that people living on farms are less likely to develop allergies and asthma than kids who live in cities. So what can we do? Well, if you have a baby, breastfeeding protects infants from developing allergies. Having a pet is perfect for getting exposure to more bacteria, and it's important to avoid unnecessary antibiotics that kill beneficial bacteria. Spending time in nature is also great for exposing young kids to a more diverse range of bacteria. It's important to note that the immune system is most susceptible to training during the first few years of life, with the first 4 years being the most crucial. There are still many unknowns when it comes to how the immune system is trained, and factors like toxins and diet may also play a role in allergic reactions and autoimmune diseases. Looking ahead, it's crucial that we identify the specific bacteria or molecules that are responsible for training the immune system. Once we know this, we can work on reintroducing them into the environment to help children develop the appropriate immune responses.